अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास सेवन, विश यू ऑल अ वेरी गुड डे। और वे क्लास, यू नो दैट वी आर डूइंग अ कॉम्प्रिहेंशन। वी हैव जस्ट कम्प्लीटेड लेसन नंबर सेवन एंड आई होप दैट यू वर एबल टू कॉम्प्रिहेंड द लेसन एंड डू द एक्सरसाइजेज एज वेल एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चन। ऑलराइट, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर एट्थ लेसन ऑफ कॉम्प्रिहेंशन एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द फर्स्ट पार्ट, लेक्चर 55। सो प्लीज क्लास, ओपन योर अंडरस्टैंड एंड कम्युनिकेट बुक नंबर टू। I've already told you that you should have your books by your sides and also pencils as well as erasers with you. Alright, so please come to the lesson number 8 of comprehension. It is advertising. Now let's look at the picture. What do you see? One is advertising milk. Drink daffodil milk and grow strong as an ox. So who is holding the milk? An ox is holding the milk. So ox is a strong animal, right? So the ad is telling you that if you drink this brand of milk, you are going to grow as strong as an ox. Look at the other picture. Step out in style. So they're saying that if you wear our brand of shoes and heels, if you wear our shoes, you are going to be, you know, in fashion. You are going to be considered fashionable. So you will be stepping out in style. Look at this, speed petrol, what is this? Please open your books, please read it out from your books. What does it say? Come to chapter, you are on chapter number 8 of your comprehension. It says speed petrol, speedy people. The word is, you know, cut, P-E-O-P is given. You know, style is also not written in the complete word is missing, it's not complete, it's incomplete. And it says speed petrol, speedy people. So speedy people, the word people is not written, you know, completely, it's incomplete word. P-E-O-P is mentioned there. It is P-E-O-P-L-E, speedy people. It's this ad is telling you that if you, you know, get petrol, no matter what car you are driving, it doesn't matter about the car, but it depends, you know, upon the petrol. If you are using speed petrol, it means that the people are also very speedy, that it's going to, you know, increase the speed of your car and you're going to look really, you know, cool in it, you know, having your friends in your car with you and driving very fast. So this petrol is going to increase the speed, which, you know, is, do you think it's true? These are just ads. What do you think is the aim, the objective behind, you know, all these things that between advertising, between ads? Why they are trying to sell milk in the first picture, but they have given a picture of an ox, which is an ox is not even related to the milk. But they are given the picture of an ox because they are trying to tell us that if you drink our milk, you will become very strong. So they are trying to incite us, they are trying to attract us towards their brand of product, right? So they are saying that if you drink milk, you will become strong. And the second ad is of shoes, and they are saying, what they are trying to tell us, they are trying to attract us towards their brand by saying that if you buy shoes from our outlet, from our company, you are going to be fashionable, you will look chic and, you know, fashionable, right? And then the last ad is of a petrol. They are saying that, okay, if you buy petrol from our brand, you know, the petrol is the same from wherever you get it. But they are saying, no, buy petrol, you will become speedy, like a speed petrol. So advertising is just a way to attract people towards, you know, attract clients and customers, to attract the people, the viewers towards, you know, their own brands, so that they will buy their things more and, you know. Alright class, come to page number 39, advertising. So you know what advertising is, right? From the picture you have guessed what is advertising and why people advertise. So I think you've got a pretty good idea just by looking at the picture. Now I'm going to read this out, but please first write the date on the top of this page. Page number 39, write today's date. This article, this passage is taken from Shops and Shopping by W.K. Brennan. Advertising. Now please, while I'm reading, please point with your fingers. Advertising can be a service to the customer. service to the customer. I have told you the meaning of service when you're doing something for someone, right? This is true when advertisements, you can say advertisements or advertisements. They are both correct. This is true when advertisements give reliable information about goods advertised. Such information is needed if the customer is to make a sensible choice when he buys it. It is useful in that it lets him know of the kinds of goods in the shops. Printed advertisements do this shop best. Customers can collect them and compare them. They can be taken along to shops and their claims checked against the actual goods in the shop. It is much harder to do this with TV or radio advertisements. The best TV and radio advertisements direct attention to printed advertisements, which can be used as suggested above. Few of them belong to this group, however. They are giving a service. They are providing a service. And it is only true if whatever the advertisement is telling you, if whatever is mentioned in the ad, like, you know, it makes you strong, it makes you fashionable, it improves the performance of, you know, the car, it makes you fairer, it gives you silky, long, healthy hair. If whatever is mentioned in the ad, in the advertisement or advertisement, if all of that is true, you know, then it is, you know, helpful. Reliable means, which is, you know, which can be, there has proof, which can be, you know, proven. Reliable is something which is true, which is trustworthy. All right. And so what does it help? The advertisement helping. It helps the customer to make a choice. Because he wants to buy clothes. He can, you know, look at the pictures and look at the brands, and then he will decide, okay, I want to buy this. I want this or that. So he is able to make a choice. Or if he is looking for, you know, something for a bag which is of a good quality, he is able to, you know, check the ads and look at the printed, and he is able to make a choice. Sometimes it happens that you want a bag but you don't know what type of a bag you should go for, what color you should go for. When you look at the ads or you look at the ads given in the brochures or in the printed material, you are able to, you know, make a choice. And also, you know, these ads, you know, they inform us about the things which we may not know about. For example, maybe there's a burger shop which has opened up nearby and we don't know anything. We don't know anything about it. We don't even know that there's a burger shop nearby. But the ad is going to inform us. It is going to tell us that, you know, there is a shop opening nearby. So it gives us information. It provides us information. It tells us about the different goods. Goods are the things, the stuff, the materials, the wares, right? Things. So it tells us about different kinds of products, the different kinds of things, and what kinds of things are available in the given shops, or, you know, in the shops which are mentioned in the ads. You can also compare, you know, things. You know, you can compare the goods or the products of one company with that of the other, and you can decide which one to go for, which one is best. But if you have, you know, printed ads, that they are very good and helpful, because you are able to make, you know, a choice, you are able to make a selection, and then, you know, if you don't get what you have ordered, you can always take that paper and you can, you know, claim to that shopkeeper, you know, to provide you with what you had wanted or to give your money back. But TV and radio, they do not help in such a way, because, you know, you cannot say, okay, I saw it on TV, because there is no proof. If you are listening on the radio or if you are watching on TV, a TV does not give you, you know, that reliable information, because you cannot say, okay, I watched it on TV. You have no proof. So the proof is that, you know, that printed material which is in your hand. Come to the next paragraph. Some advertisements are not very useful to the customer. Instead of helping him to satisfy his real needs, they set out to make him want things. So they are not very useful because we are eating, you know, our normal healthy food, but we will see, you know, junk food ad on the TV, or, you know, a burger or anything, and we will say, okay, wow, yummy, it looks so tasty, I want to order a burger. Instead of eating, you know, healthy foods at home, we are going to order junk food. from outside and we are going to have it delivered, or we will go out to eat for dinner or for, you know, to a hotel. So instead of, you know, showing us things which we really need, we are shown things which, you know, they make us want them. They paint such a pretty picture of burgers or, you know, eatable things. And, you know, we are using our normal cream, face cream, and we are okay with it. But they will give you such ads saying, for a fairer, for a smoother complexion, use this cream. And for healthy hair, just use our shampoo. And you are going to, you know, just forget about your shampoo or your cream. You're going to throw them away or stop using them. And you're going to waste your money and buy expensive creams, expensive products. So they make us want to buy things. So, fourth line, second paragraph, the people who produce them understand our weaknesses. So, they set out to make us believe that what they advertise will make us cleverer, prettier, more handsome. If only we use it. Or they suggest that people who are all these things use their product. The voice on TV says, get away, people use XYZ petrol. The screen shows a picture of a petrol pump and a fast, expensive car owned by a boy with a pretty girl. The pretty girl is, you know, just advertising. They drive off to a wonderful country or a lovely beach. Some people may feel that clever, successful people use XYZ petrol. Some might choose that petrol next time they fill up their car. Soft drink advertisements often work in the same way. They suggest that everybody drinks soft drinks. Most of the time, they are trying to get people to ask for a certain brand of soft drink. This kind of advertising is very well done on TV or on the cinema screen. Other forms of advertising can also be used in this way. Often the TV advertisement is backed up in newspapers and on hoardings. We should be on guard. It's our money thereafter. So, they are advertisements which are not useful because they don't tell us things which we need. They make us want things which we don't need. And, you know, because they know our requirements, because first they try to understand the people they are trying to sell their products to. They know that there are some people who are losing hair, there are some people who are short-heighted, there are some people who are dark-complexioned or who have short hair. And then, you know, keeping all this in mind, they are going to make ads. They're going to make ads so attractive, so colorful, so inciting that they incite the viewers, they instigate the viewers to buy their products. This is what they do. They say, okay, if you buy our product, you will become more clever or pretty or handsome. Whereas it's not really true in all the cases, but some information is reliable, not all. And they say, if you use our petrol, people start thinking, okay, the people who are clever, look at the big car they own, look at the beautiful girl, and look at the country they are going to and the beach. And they start thinking, oh, if we buy this petrol, will our life become like this? So they will just go and buy that petrol. You know soft drinks, how harmful they are. Soft drinks are not useful in any way. But the ads make them so healthy and they make us believe that they are so healthy, so essential in our life. Everyone is doing it, so why don't you also, you know, start drinking soft drinks? So they are just trying to attract us towards their brand. This is what the TV advertisements do. Alright. Look at the last paragraph. Some advertisements mislead customers by using part of the truth to suggest something false. The advertisement says, the makers of Tuva washing machine recommend Jazz washing powder. So they do. But they recommend 6 other washing powders as well. What do they do? There's a washing machine which has, you know, which is quite famed, which has got quite a name to it, which has become quite famous, acquired quite fame and a name, and built up quite a name for itself. They will take that company or that brand's name and they will say, okay, this company, this washing machine, this brand, it recommends, it prefers Jazz washing powder. So, you know, buy this powder. So they are just telling you part of the truth, not the whole truth. Because in reality, maybe that brand or that washing machine is promoting 6 washing powders, not just one. But they will only mention that one powder because they are only telling you part of the truth, not the whole truth. The advertisement does not say that Tuber recommended only jazz. It says, it does not say that only jazz, but they will say, okay, they recommend jazz. So they're not trying to be, you know, they are just trying to mislead you. They're not really trying to tell you a lie because they're not saying that they only recommended. They're just saying that Tuber recommends jazz. So you will say, think, oh, wow. So Tuber recommends, so maybe Tuber is only using jazz. Whereas it is recommending many other products as well. But they are just trying to mislead you, misguide you. It is skillfully made to give the idea to that idea to the careless reader, listener or viewer. Someone who is listening carelessly, you know, or reading or watching will, you know, believe that, oh, so such a good company, such a famed company or a brand is using jazz, so I will also use jazz. At its best, advertisement or advertising can be useful to the customer. So it can be useful, it tells you, gives you information, it helps you in choosing, in selection, selecting. At its worst, it can mislead him, misguide him. Many newspapers check on the advertisements which they publish. Publish means to print out something. They check on the goods for which the advertisements make claims. Many newspapers, they confirm the reliability, the trustworthiness of the advertisements. But not all. Most newspapers are very careful about the small advertisements which they try to sell goods directly to the readers by post. So they try to be very careful to find out that if the information is authentic, it is original, it is true or not. Many newspapers print information about this on their small advertisement page. Advertising has become a very big business and good firms in it do all they can to make sure it is conducted with some attention to truth. So those people who are advertising, who are making advertisements, they make sure that it's not all false. There is some part of truth in it, right? This is a help to the customer, but the only real safeguard for the customer is his own alertness. Safeguard, protection. Only security, only protection is by being alert, on your guard, right? Alright class, come to exercise number A, meaning in context. Explain the meaning of each word and then use it in a sentence. So you are going to do this homework. You have to explain the meaning. I have given you the meanings of many of these words, not all of them. So the words which are easy, which are very easy for you, I have not given the meanings. You are going to find out the meaning yourself. Hoardings, are the boards. Mislead, I have told you, recommend to, you know, recommend means to suggest something, right? To, they recommend it, they suggest. Business, you know what business is, I have told you the meaning of safeguard. Service is given. Advertisement, they are ads given in the newspaper or it can be on the TV or on the radio, in brochures as well. Alright, claims I have given. Create is to, you know, make something. Weaknesses. Please try to find out by yourself. You know what a weakness is. Something which is, you know, which is flawed. Which is, you know, something which is vulnerable. Weaknesses from weak. Something which is vulnerable. So class, you have to make sentences. Alright. Now, we are going to do part A. Meaning in context. You are going to explain the meaning. A lot of the words, the meanings are already mentioned and the rest I have told you. And you are going to write their meaning first. You will write a word and in front of it you will write its meaning. And then you are going to use this word in a sentence. Alright class, this work will be done on your notebooks. Please remember to do it on your notebooks, okay? Write the date, comprehension, lesson number, topic number, then write the question. And then write one word in front of the word, write the meaning after dash, and then use it in a sentence. So there are 10 words in all, okay? This you will do on your notebooks, and this will be done on your understand and communicate book number 2. This work you will do on your books. You have to choose the best explanation for each phrase. So you have got multiple choice here. You have to choose the best suitable answer. Give reliable information in first paragraph, second line means first passage. It's all considered one passage, okay? Give reliable information means make deceiving statements. प्रोवाइड सीक्रेट इन्फॉर्मेशन, प्रोवाइड डिपेंडेबल इन्फॉर्मेशन. डू यू थिंक रिलायबल इज डिसीविंग? डिसीव मीन्स टू मेक अ फूल ऑफ समथिंग. नो, डिसीविंग इज टू फूल समवन, टू मिस गाइड समवन, टू मिस लीड समवन. नो. डज इट प्रोवाइड सीक्रेट इन्फॉर्मेशन? नो. द बेस्ट आंसर इज सी, प्रोवाइड डिपेंडेबल इन्फॉर्मेशन, रिलायबल समथिंग ट्रस्टवर्दी विच इज डिपेंडेबल. बी, मेक अ सेंसिबल चॉइस. All right, class, these three you are going to do yourself. You are going to tick or circle the best answer. All right? This will just take you 5 to 10 minutes. You have to circle or tick the best answer. Make a sensible choice means choose intelligently, choose seriously, decide without thinking. Which is the best answer? C. Do this job best means perform this work most effectively, do this work cheaply, carry out this work easily. D. To satisfy his real needs means to make him desire for more, to meet his actual requirements, or to make him contented. So class, you are not going to have any difficulty in finding out the best answer, because you know the line number is mentioned here. You must read the statements and to know which is the best suitable answer. All right, to find out the meanings, if you are confused, please listen to my video, my lecture again, or just read that text. So you're going to have no difficulty in finding out the meanings. All right, class, this is your homework for today. Sorry, I have missed one part. E. To be on guard. Be on guard means be nasty. Nasty is someone who is rude, cruel, mean. Be demanding. Demanding is always asking for something, always wanting something. Be very, very means, you know, not be on your, you know, be alert, be on your guard. So be on guard means be wary, right? All right, class, this is your homework for today. Wish you all the very best. Allah Hafiz.